Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's video is 3 low bun hairstyles. Comment down below if you have a favorite. I'm not gonna say which one is mine until the end of the video, so if you're curious, stay tuned. If you're new to my channel, subscribe, click that bell, then you'll never miss any future videos, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to begin with my hair parted on the right side. Then I'm going to divide out a section of hair on the left side of my head from the part down to my ear. I'm going to clip this hair aside to use for the braid later on. Now I'm going to pin the crown section. So I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the sides of my head going towards the back of my head. And I'm going to slightly twist this hair towards the left side and then pin it in place using a couple bobby pins. Then I'm going to go back over the crown section and gently pinch and pull on small pieces of hair to loosen them, and this will create some volume and dimension in the crown section. Now I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So I'm first dividing out a few pieces of hair to frame my face on the right side, and then I'm going to combine the remaining hair together at the nape of my neck. Using an elastic band, I'm going to tie the hair together into a ponytail. And once it's all tied off, I'm going to create a rope braid with my ponytail to use to create the bun. So I'm going to split the ponytail into 2 equal sections. Then I'm going to cross the left section over the right while also twisting the 2 sections towards the left side. And I'm going to continue this pattern working down to the ends of the hair. And then once the whole section is twisted up, I'm going to wrap this twist into the bun. So I'm going to wrap it clockwise around the base of the ponytail so it creates the shape of the bun. And then using bobby pins, I'm going to pin the hair in place. So I'm going to slide them into the hair so it secures the twist against my head. And I like to slide these in towards the center of the bun so they stay hidden underneath the hair. And I just put one in wherever I'm holding the hair with my fingers. So I just work my way around the bun, pinning it wherever it feels loose. And then with the ends, I'm going to tuck them under the bun and pin them in place using another bobby pin. Now I'm going to create the braid portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to let down the hair on the left side of my head and divide off a small section near the part to begin my braid. I'm creating a fishtail braid, so I'm going to start the braid like a regular 3-strand braid by crossing the 2 side strands once over the middle strand. Then by combining 2 of the strands together, I can switch to a fishtail braid. So I'm essentially taking small pieces from one side and crossing them over and combining them into the opposite side section. I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid to create a lace style braid. This type of braid will give the hairstyle an overall softer look. So to create the fishtail braid, I'm crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side, while also picking up new sections of hair from underneath the bottom of the braid and crossing these over the top, adding them into the top or right section of the braid. So I'm taking a small piece from the right side and crossing it over to the left. I'm taking a small piece from the left side, crossing it over to the right, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over to the right side as well. I'm taking a small piece from the right side and crossing it over to the left. I'm taking a small piece from the left side and crossing it over to the right, while also picking up a new section of hair from the bottom side of the braid and crossing it over, adding it into the right side as well. And I'm going to create the braid along the left side of my head. And as I am braiding, I'm also going to make sure to leave out small sections of hair along the hairline to frame my face once the style is done. So I'm continuing the lace style fishtail braid, working my way along the left side of my head until I've brought in all of the hair that I want to on this side. Then once that's done, I'm simply going to continue braiding the fishtail braid a little further down by crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side to ensure the braid will reach around the back of my head so I can pin it above the bun at the back. So once the braid reaches far enough, I'm going to bring it around the back of my head and lay it above the top of the bun. Then I'm going to fold it under and pin it in place using bobby pins. Again, I like to pin the braid from the right side. And I also like to slide them underneath the hair so they don't stick out and show. Then I can kind of go back over the braid and gently pull on the edges to make the braid look a little bit wider so it's easier to see. And I'm also going to just make sure to pin down any ends that are still sticking out with some bobby pins. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to begin by designing how I want the style to look from the front. And this will help me decide where I want my braids to be. So I'm going to place one braid on the left side of my head near the top. So I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair for my braid. And I'm just going to braid this into a regular 3-strand braid. So I'm dividing the section into 3 smaller pieces, and I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side pieces. And you can either cross the side sections over the middle or under the middle. I like the way the beginning of the braid looks when it's crossed under, so that's why I'm doing it this way. And I'm just going to repeat the steps crossing the side strands under the middle strand, working my way down to the bottom. And once the braid reaches close enough to the ends, I'm going to take a comb and back comb the bottom of the braid upwards. This will kind of tangle the hair a little bit so the braid doesn't unravel, and then I won't need to use any elastic bands to tie off the end of the braid. Next, I want a braid at the back of my head, and I'm going to repeat the same steps as before and braid this into a regular 3-strand braid. And then, of course, once the braid reaches near the ends, I'm going to gently back comb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to create a third braid on the right side of my head. So again, I'm dividing off a small section of hair, and I'm going to braid this into another 3-strand braid, crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side strands. And then I'm going to gently back comb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to create one more braid at the back of my head. I want to have enough braids that they're noticeable, but not so many that it's just a bunch of braids in the hairstyle. So I'm braiding one more braid down the back of my head, starting at my crown. Once all of the braids are done, I'm going to divide off the top section of my head to be pinned as the crown section. And I'm going to twist the section together towards the left side and then slide my pin in horizontally from the left side. And I like to just hook a bit of hair on the right side and then bring the pin over the top and push it in from the left to help hold the hair in place without the bobby pin showing. And then I usually slip in a second bobby pin just to make sure the section doesn't fall loose. So now I'm going to combine the rest of my hair together and tie it off using a hairband. I want to make sure to tie off the hair right underneath the crown section, so when I do my bun, it will sit right where I want it to, and this will make it a little bit more flush with the crown section. But now with my ponytail, I'm going to braid this into another 3-strand braid. So I'm dividing the hair into 3 equal sections, and I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand. So I'm crossing the left strand over the middle, then crossing the right strand over the middle, and I'm going to continue this pattern until the braid reaches down near the bottom of the hair. And then once the braid reaches down low enough that the hair is getting too short to braid, I'm going to wrap it into the bun. So I'm going to take the braid and wrap it over the hairband towards the right side. And I want to make sure to lay the braid flat over the hairband so you can see the pattern of the braid. And then I'm going to continue wrapping the ends around the hairband so they tuck underneath the bun at the nape of my neck, under the hairband. And now I need to pin the bun in place. And I like to hook a bit of hair in the bobby pin and then push it in towards the center of the bun so it's against my head. I usually begin with a pin on the right side, then one underneath, and then one on the left side. And then I'll work my way around again, repinning wherever the bun feels like it needs a little bit more support. I really love how this hairstyle turned out. I feel like this bun looks a lot more complicated than it actually was, so I hope you'll try this out. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this hairstyle. For the third hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing my hair into 2 sections, a left side and a right side. I'm going to create a zigzag part line down the center of the back of my head. And this will just make hiding that part line a little bit easier.
So once I've divided my hair into two sections, I'm going to tie off the right side to start with the left. So I'm going to divide out a few small pieces to frame my face and then pick up a section on the left side of the part for the braid. I'm creating a French braid again, so I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand. Then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections into the braid. So I'm crossing the other side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand as well. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also bringing in new sections of hair and incorporating them into the braid. And I'm going to continue the braid down this side of my head. So I'm alternating between crossing each side strand over the middle strand while also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the braid along this side of my head. Once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to combine it all together and then tie it off using a clear elastic band. Now I'm going to repeat the exact same steps with the hair on the right side of my head. So I'm dividing off a section near the part line and dividing it into three smaller pieces. And I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand. And then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid as well. And I'm just going to repeat this process, continuing the braid along this side of my head. I'm alternating between crossing the side strands over the middle strand while bringing in new sections of hair from both the part line at the back of my head and the hairline until all of the hair is brought into the braid, or at least until the braid reaches the nape of my neck. And then I'm going to combine all of the hair together and tie it off using a clear elastic band. I'm going to take the hair elastic and pull it partway down the ponytail to create a small loop in the hair. I'm going to take the ends and I'm going to divide them into two equal sections and then wrap each one over the top of the bun, crossing them at the top, and then wrap them back down so they're underneath the loop. I'm going to take a clear elastic band and tie the two ends together underneath the bun. I think out of all of the styles, this one is my favorite. I just think it's such a cute look with the double braids and the messy bun.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Comment down below which of the three you liked the best. Be sure to subscribe and click that bell if you're new, then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.